You gotta find me first.
Jeez. Oh. I know you're in there. Gotcha. Come on, get your butt out.
Okay.
No more hiding. Seriously.
Okay. What do I have to do?
You tidy the mess in our room, and I take care of the laundry. Cool?
Again? We always have to clean everything. I don't wanna.
Yeah, I hear you. Never mind, okay?
Cool. Thanks, Sean.
All right, let's get it over with. How many programs does this thing have? Okay, it will do. Come on, man. I've put all your toys in the trash, dude.
What? Really?
Of course not. But next time you bail on me, maybe I will. See you tonight, buddy. I don't know when Daniel will be able to go back to his school. Claire can draw pretty damn good. Guess it runs in the family.
Careful! Sean!
Oh, shit!
Got you!
Seriously, man!
Pussy.
Tried one of Claire's books yesterday. It's basically a telenovela with white old women. Oh, this looks cool. Too bad it's broken. I heard Claire rehearse some songs. She's got the groove. All right. Time to see the sun again. Okay. Time to burn off some calories. What do you say?
Haha! Yes! So good to be outside. Reminds me of the cabin. Right?
Oh! Ow!
Oh! 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 Oh!
Watch out!
Get ready for storage wars.
What's wrong?
Frozen shut. Of course.
Sean, look! Did you see that?
Yeah. We did. It looks like you're okay, though.
You were almost floating.
I was. I could feel myself in the air. It was awesome.
That t-shirt is wicked. Who's your favorite superhero? I love Power Bear!
Oh, man! I have the Mega Power Bear. You should check it out.
Dude, that's so cool.
Chris, oh, God. Look, I am so sorry. Are you okay?
Dad, I'm fine. I promise.
Are you sure? Listen, I shouldn't... Do you know them?
It's okay, Dad. They're cool. He loves superheroes, even Power Bear.
Ah, gotcha. Hey there. Are you staying with the Reynolds?
Oh, yeah. They're our grandparents.
I see. Oh, geez, Chris. You don't have any damn shoes on. I'm sorry, buddy. Let's get you inside.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine.
Sure. No problem.
Cool. See you around, then.
Thanks, guys. See you later?
Yes, we will.
Daniel, did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall? Really?
No, you did the right thing. But listen, we can't let anybody know. We have to keep a low profile out here.
He's like my age. I bet you would have done the same exact thing. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad, dude. It's over. Daniel. Remember that we're hiding out, so no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay? fuck. That kitten never listens. Claire? Steven? Anybody home? Well, looks like I'm home alone. Oh, right. Sunday morning. Claire and Steven must be at church. We had a good time decorating the tree together last night. Daniel loved it. Well, maybe I could use the phone while they're away. Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours. Maybe I could use Steven's laptop? It's been ages since I've had news from the real world. I could just delete my browser history after I'm done. Jeez. Steven went search crazy on us. Look at this. These articles are almost a month old. Maybe they stopped looking for us? What the hell is this? Had no idea Steven could fall for this bullshit conspiracy theories. Jeez. Steven went search crazy on us. Well, Brody, if we ever make it home, wherever that is, he'll be much, much welcome.
Holy shit. Who are these assholes? That's some fucked up hate speech. What the hell is wrong with Lila? Maybe I should call her while there's nobody home. I should really call Lila to check on her. Maybe risky, but I need to know what's going on with Lila. Just a quick call can't hurt us. I need to know if Lila's okay.
Hello?
Mrs. Park?
Yes?
Could I talk to Lila, please?
Who's asking?
It's, Adam.
Sweetie. You know Lila's not here. She's not back from the clinic yet.
Oh, yeah. The clinic?
You know, in Bellevue, where you visited her last week. The doctors did say she might be coming home next month. We hope.
So, she's okay?
She's better. Getting better, at least. But she keeps asking me about the Diaz boys. Always. It's time for her to let them go. They're not coming back. And they shouldn't. Anyway, sorry I got carried away. I will definitely let Lila know you called.
Wait. Mrs. Park, I...
Goodbye, Adam. Thank you for calling.
Why did I lie? She must have recognized my voice. Fuck, Lila. What kind of friend am I? I can't be there for her. Stop thinking about that. Time to go get Daniel. Okay, let's get this Brack back home now. Why does Daniel never listen? Maybe I'm too soft with him.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things. Objects. With my mind.
Oh. A superpower. Really?
Yes.
Well, that's pretty cool, Chris. So, you're like a superhero?
I'm Captain Spirit. I can bend any matter to my will. But that's my secret identity, so you can't tell anybody.
Oh, the secret, Captain Spirit.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding. Oh yeah, we need a team signal.
Totally! I'm gonna be Super Wolf. What's your super name, Sean?
How about if I'm like the mentor? Like Professor D or something?
Yeah. We'll figure out another cool name for you.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll. Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Sorry, man. You're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah, they share a lot of things. As thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes! Can't wait to see all the decorations! And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
Well, they'll worry if we leave the house. And remember, you still have to get better, Daniel.
Sean, come on. You know I haven't done anything fun since I got sick. It's the first time I've been out for days.
We won't be gone for long. The market's only a few miles away. Anyway, they'll be at the service for at least another hour.
Yeah, Sean, I can show Daniel around. You can come with us. Please say yes.
Please, please, please.
Okay, you win. Not a fair fight. So let's go.
Yes! Yeah!
See? Dangerous. Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming, too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spirit's friends and his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Look closely. Okay. Careful. It may be tricky. The bad guys, the good guys. Not that easy, right?
Okay, how did I do?
Not bad. You're almost right. It was a bit tricky. Okay, let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit, the good guys. There's the Forest Warrior, Power Bear, Marty Rex, and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer. But he's out in the garden. But they're all working for Mantroid, who's the real supervillain.
So, where is he?
Hiding out on his evil planet, waiting for me. But Captain Spirit and Super Wolf will make sure he doesn't hurt anyone.
Yeah, strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah, about that. Aren't you afraid? Maybe it's not a good idea to disclose all your powers like this. That Mantroid guy could be watching you, you know?
Even better. So he'll know he better stay away from us.
Anyway, you shouldn't let anyone know about this. Not even your father.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't want to freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
Well, your dad is cool. He totally hooked you up with that treehouse.
Yeah, he let Steven build it for me. It's my flying fortress.
I bet. There's no stopping him from building things.
Well, Captain Spirit had to help him, of course.
Well, the flying fortress needs fixing now.
Yeah, that sucks. Dad couldn't fix it yesterday. He was not feeling well. He told me he'll do it when we're back from the market.
That's cool.
Ah, too cold.
Sorry, the water eater is still broken.
There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey! Pro tip, don't go in there.
Yeah.
Okay, squad, let's roll. You need my jacket? I don't want you catching another cold.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
And don't be waving your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah. Remember, Daniel, don't mess around.
All right. Jeez.
Okay, buddy. You ready?
Yeah. Hey!
You guys go ahead and we'll come back to meet you, okay? Brothers meeting.
Sure.
But...
don't get lost.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing? I can't believe it. How many times do we have to keep going over the rules?
Don't show the power. I know. But Chris thinks he can do all this cool stuff. I wish he could. He reminds me of Noah. I just miss having friends, Sean.
Listen, I understand, but we have to be extra careful out here. You can't let people see you. You know the rules.
Yes, I know the rules. But I'm careful. I only do things when it's me and Chris. Nobody sees us.
Yeah, nobody but me. What if it was Chris's dad? Or grandma? Or a cop? Or...
Okay. I get it. But I'm careful.
That's not enough. You have to be extra careful.
All right. I swear I will.
deal. I'm counting on you and Enno.
Can I go see Chris now?
Yeah, let's go. But don't forget what I said.
Wow! So many trees! Ugh. They look like giant cocoons. Creepy. You coming, Sean?
Don't worry. I'll be around.
Nothing. I'll tell you later. So, what do we do?
We have to pick the one we like. Can Daniel help, Dad?
Of course he can.
Awesome. Come on, no time to lose.
Okay, just pick the one you like and come get me. Deal?
Deal.
I've never been on such a dangerous mission.
Yeah, these wild trees are just waiting to eat us.
We'll have to tame the one we want.
Jeez. Daniel Snowman wasn't that creepy after all.
Too thin.
You're right. We need a strong tree to protect our base from evil elves.
All right, sweetie. See anything you like?
Let's look at another one. Ooh, this one is cool.
I agree. Adding it to the top three list.
Let's look at another one.
Come on, you want it to come? Stop howling, bitch.
Giant cocoons.
Better be careful. Snow spiders must be lurking around.
Don't worry. Captain Spirit will crush them.
Dad pushed every year to get a plastic tree. But we never surrendered.
Let's look at another one. This one looks like a cactus. A snow cactus.
Dear Santa, we've been good kids this year. Please explain this hot mess.
Tell me if you need anything, okay?
Sure. I'm fine for now.
This is so different from Seattle. Don't know if I can get used to it. Is that a yo-yo? Daniel had one back home. Bet he'd love this.
We only sell handmade.
Funny how all small towns always sell the same
handcrafted crap. Hey. Hi.
Good morning, young man. It's nice to see a new face in this old town.
Thanks. It's a super cool market you got here.
Small towns are the best for Christmas. Who are you staying with?
The Reynolds?
Everybody knows Steven. He was Beaver Creek's fire chief years ago. You're not his grandson, are you?
Yes, I am.
Oh, that's great. He told me about you, but that was a long time ago. It's been a few years, right?
Yeah. Family stuff.
I bet. Anyway, look around, and if you find anything you want, I'll give you the special Reynolds discount. You won't find better deals in Beaver Creek.
Funny how all small towns always sell the same handcrafted crap.
Quiet morning.
Looks like someone went nuts over these blocks. I wonder what will happen to the trees no one buys. I wonder what will happen to the trees no one buys.
Good shape, pretty thick. Ooh, broken branch, refused.
This one's all dry.
Not bad.
They kind of all look the same.
I think this one is too big. There are so many trees. How are we gonna find the one?
How can they sell so many trees in such a small town? Behold, the giant condom machine. I'm glad Daniel made a new friend. He needed this.
Ask Grandma and Grandpa.
We can do it all together. I'm sure Dad would agree.
It'd be awesome.
Whoa. The guy who painted that, he must have been seriously high. I should take a good look at the subject before drawing. Okay, got it. I've looked enough. Time to draw now. This place is nice. Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want. Cool. I think I'm ready to draw this. Time to take the pen, dude. I need to train my visual
What are you drawing? Whoa! It's so cool! Are you like a professional?
Nah. More like the opposite.
You could draw comic books. The awesome adventures of Captain Spirit and Super Wolf.
Pretty rad for Hollywood name. Yeah. I'll think about it.
Hey, can you add something funny to your drawing?
Funny? Like what?
I don't know. Something cool.
Okay. Big question. Zombies or UFO? What about a giant spaceship flying over Beaver Creek? Nope. I can't do anything without looking up first. I've looked enough. Time to draw now.
I hope I can draw like you one day.
I'm sure you will, man.
Did I lock the shop yesterday?
It's not much, but she probably needs it more than me right now.
Gotta order more yule logs tomorrow.
Hi, everybody. We're taking a year off to run away from cops. Daniel has got telekinesis now. Truly special. Hope you're doing well.
Gotta order more yule logs tomorrow.
Ugh.
It's weird to have all this food around after a month of ravioli diet.
Too bad we can't come and see. Maybe we'll get some leftover pies and eggnog, at least.
Where's the nativity scene? Jason was supposed to set it up. Damn it. Can't trust you, man.